The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, second chapter, text number 18, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on August 24, 1973, in London, England.
Only the material body of the indestructible, immeasurable, and eternal living entity is subject to destruction. Therefore, fight, O descendant of Bharata.
Antavantaimi deha nittasya apta sharira sharirina. This is Puranama. Sharirin. So, sharirin or shariri means the proprietor of the sharir or body. Sharir means his body, and sharirin, one who possesses the body. So, Puranama is sharirina. In a varieties of ways, Krishna is convincing Arjuna that the soul is different from this body. So this body, antavat, it will be finished. However, you may try so scientifically, applying cosmetic and other things. You cannot save the body. That is not possible. Antavat. Anta means end. And both means possessing. So, you have got your duty to fight, and you are lamenting that the body of your grandfather or teacher or kinsman, they will be destroyed, and you will be unhappy. That's all right, you will be unhappy. But even if you do not fight, their bodies will be finished today or tomorrow or say a few years after. So why should you go back from discharging your duty? This is the point. And so far, the soul is concerned of your grandfather, teacher, and others. They are nitya, eternal, already explained. Nittasya ukta. Now, Krishna here also says, ukta. Ukta means it is said. Not that dogmatically I am speaking, I am putting up some theory. No. It is said. It is already settled, it is already ascertained, and in the Vedic literature, by authorities, it is so said. This is the way of presenting evidence. Even Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, he does not theorize. He said it is said, authorized. Anasina apramayas. Anasina. Nasina means destructible. And anasina means not destructible. Sharirina, the soul. Anasina. It will never be destroyed. And apramayas. Apramayas are immeasurable. It cannot be measured also. In the Vedic literature, the measurement is described there, but you cannot measure it. Anything, so many things are described in the Vedic literature. So you are so advanced in scientific knowledge, But neither you can say that it is not fair. Neither you can estimate. Just like in the Padma Purana, the varieties of living entities are expressed. Jalajanam lakhani, the aquatic animals or living entities are 900,000. So you cannot say, no, it is not 900, it is less or more. It is not possible for you to see within the water how many varieties are. You might have, the biologist, they might have experimented, but it is not possible to see 900,000 formed. That is not possible. Jalajanam lakhani, sthavara lakhavinshat. So that trees and plants, there are 2 million varieties. Sthavara lakhavinshati, krimayo rudra sankaka. And the insects, they are 1,100,000. So it is a puzzling thing that how Vedic literature places everything very correctly. 900,000, 1,100,000, 2 million, as they are. This is called realization. So we take it for granted that our facility is because we accept the Vedas as authority. Therefore, the knowledge is there ready. If somebody asks me or you, can you say how many forms of living entities are there within the water? It is very difficult. Even the biologist cannot say, although they are very expert. I cannot say. But our facilities, we can immediately say, there are 900,000. Although I have never experimented, neither seen personally. But because it is explained in the Vedic literature, I can say you correct. Therefore, in the Vedanta Sutra, it is said that you want to see or perceive directly anything. Just like so many rascals come, they challenge, can you show me God? So, yes, we can show you God, provided you have got the eyes. God can be seen by different type of eyes, not these eyes. That is stated in the Shastra. Atha Sri Krishna Namadi Navaved Grahyam Indriyai. Indriya means these senses, these material senses. With these material senses, you cannot experience directly what is the form of the Lord, what is His quality, what does He do, so many things you want to know about the Supreme. But Shastra describes the qualities of the Lord, the form of the Lord, the activities of the Lord. You can learn Shastra Jyoni Tyat. Jyoni means source, Shastra Jyoni. Shastra Chokhushyat. Your eyes should be this Shastra, not this blunt eyes. Everything we also experience by Shastra, by book. So, we have to see through the authorized book the description which is beyond our perception. Achinta phaluri bhava natas tarkena yujat. Tarkena by argument, which is beyond your sense perception. So many things. Even if we see daily so many planets, stars in the sky, but we have no information. They are going directly to see the moon planet, but hopelessly coming back. It is very doubtful to say. And they have got a dogmatic impression. They accept this planet, in other planets, so many, there is no life. These are not perfect understanding. From Shastra Jani, if you want to see through the Shastra, there is a moon planet. We have got information from Srimad Bhagavatam that there the people, they live for 10,000s of years. And what is that measurement of year? Our 6 months equal to their 1 day. Now, such 10,000s of years, just imagine. It is called Daiva Barsha. Daiva Barsha means a year according to the demigod's calculation. Just like Brahma's day, that is demigod's calculation. Sahasra bhujuga parjantam arahajyat brahmano vidu. We have got information from Bhagavad Gita. Krishna says that they calculate the years of the demigod. Everyone's year is calculated. This is called, and this is accepted by the modern science, relative truth or the law of relativity. A small ant, he has got also 100 years age. But the ant's 100 years and our 100 years different. This is called relative. According to your size of body, everything in relationship, our 100 years and Brahma's 100 years, that is different. Therefore, Krishna said, calculate like this. Sahasra yuga parjantam arahajyat brahmano vidu. Now, to try to understand what is the age of Brahma by calculating 1 day, your sahasra yuga, we have got 4 yugas, satya, treta, dapar, kali, these are called 4. This calculation is 43,000 of years. That is the sum total of the 4 yugas. 18, 12, 8 and 4. How many comes? 18 and 12? 30. And then 8, 38, then 4. This is rough calculation. 42, 43. Then sahasra yuga parjantam. So many years. Sahasra yuga parjantam. Arhat. Arhat means day. Sahasra yuga parjantam. Arhat jat brahmano vidu. This is the 1 day of Brahma. 1 day means morning to evening. 4,300,000 of years, your calculation. Therefore, these things are to be understood through this Shastra. Otherwise you have no knowledge. You cannot calculate, you cannot go to Brahma, you cannot go even to the moon planet. And what to speak of? Brahmalok is the ultimate, the remotest part of this universe. So, by your direct experience, you cannot calculate, and neither you can go. They estimate, the modern aeronautics, they estimate that in order to go to the topmost planet, we require 40,000 of years by going in the light year. That is just like light year, we have got calculated. So, we cannot estimate by direct perception, even in this material world. And what to speak of the spiritual world? Not. Panthast koti satavarsa sampragamma vayu rathapi manasu manipungavana. By mental, manipunga means mental speculation. You can go on mental speculating, but if you do, even for many hundreds and thousands of years, it is not possible to calculate. You have to accept this truth through the Shastra, otherwise it is not possible. Therefore Krishna says, nitya sukta sarir ukta. Ukta means it is said. Not that I am presenting some dogma, although he can do so, he is Supreme Personality. This is the method. Unless there is ukta, said by authorities, previous authorities, acharyas, you cannot say anything. This is called parampara. You try to understand with your intelligence, but you cannot make any addition or alteration. That is not possible. Therefore it is called nitya sokta. It is said. It is already settled. You cannot argue. Nitya sokta sarivina anasina aparamesa immeasurable. Now, this soul, as in the previous verse we have understood, avinashi tutadvidhi jena sarvamidam tapam. This is not measurement of the soul, but the power of the soul. You can measure, but not the soul. It is not possible. Soul is so small that it is not possible. You have no measuring means, and because now our material senses, it is not possible. You can simply understand by consciousness. Just like when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu fainted in the Jagannath temple, Sarvamo Bhattacharya examined that there was no consciousness. Even the abdomen was not moving. When actually you have consciousness and you breathe, the abdomen moves. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's abdomen was tested by Sarvamo Bhattacharya. It was also not moving. So he thought that this sannyasi might have died. But he again tried. He brought a little cotton swab and put before his nostrils. And when he saw the swab, the fibers a little moving, then he became hopeful. Yes. So everything has got a different type of calculation, measurement. But so far the soul is concerned, it is said here, aprameya so. There is no soul of measurement. There is no soul. Therefore, the so-called materialist science, they say there is no soul. No, there is soul. This is the proof, there is soul. This is the proof. What is that proof? First of all, there is consciousness. This is the proof. But you cannot measure. The place is also located. The soul is there in the heart. Ishvara sarvabhutanam riddhesa arjuna tishtati. So, the soul is in the heart And Krishna is also in the heart, because they remain both together. So place is also located. You can perceive also by consciousness that there is presentation of soul. But if you want to measure by experiment, that is not possible. Therefore it is called aprameya. Prameya means direct perception. I can see, or I can touch, I can handle. So that is, Krishna says, no, it is not possible. Aprameya. Then how I shall accept? But Krishna says, no. How I can believe Krishna? Krishna says, ukta. It is already settled by authorities, ukta. This is parampara. Krishna also says ukta. Krishna does not say that I speak. No. Ukta. There is Vedic evidence. Where it is? In the Upanishads, there is just like balagra satabhagasthas satadha kulpitasya bhaga jiva savijnaya sacha anantaya kalpitasya. It is in the Upanishad. Sita satara Upanishad. This is called Vedic evidence. And another, in the Srimada Bhagavatam, there is evidence. What is that? Kesagra satabhagasya satadha sadisham jiva sukshma sukshma, very fine, jiva sukshma sarupa I am asankhaya perfect. This jiva, not 1, 2, 3, 4, you cannot calculate, asankhaya. So these are evidences in the Vedic literature. So you have to accept it. Krishna confirms it. And actually also cannot measure. But we get evidence, the presence of the soul, presence of the soul. Still, how you can say there is no soul? No. This is foolishness. The whole world is going on under this foolishness. Not only now, before also, like Charvaka Muni, he was atheist, he did not believe. Lord Buddha also said like that, but he cheated. He knew everything because he is incarnation of God. But he had to cheat the people in that way, because they are not intelligent. Why not intelligent? Because they were killers of animals, they lost their intelligence. Kesavadhitas, Buddha Sarira, Jaya Jagadishahari. Those were animal killers. Their brain is dull as stone. They cannot understand it. Therefore, meat eating should be stopped. In order to revive the finer tissues of the brain to understand subtle things, one must give up meat eating. Vina pasurna, it is the statement of the king. What is it? Not the district. Parikshit Maharaj. He said that God consciousness, Krishna consciousness, cannot be understood by the animal killer. Vina pasurna. Nirvitta tarsai rupogiyamana. You'll find those are animal killers. The so-called Christians and Mohammedans, they cannot understand. They're simply fanatics. Cannot understand what is soul, what is God. They have got some theories and they are thinking we are religionists. What is seen, what is pious activities, these things are not understood by them because they are animal killers. It is not possible. Therefore, Lord Buddha propagated ahimsa. Ahimsa. Because he saw the whole human race is going to hell by this animal killing. Let me stop them so that they may, in future they may become sober. Sadaya ridaya darshita, two sides. First of all, you are very much compassionate that poor animals, they are being killed. And another side, he saw the whole human race is going to hell. So let me do something. Therefore, he had to deny the existence of the soul because their brain will not tolerate such things. Therefore, he did not say anything of the soul or God. He said that you stop animal killing. If I pinch you, you feel pain. Why should you give pain to others? Never mind, he has no soul. That's all right. He did not talk anything about soul. So these people say the animals have no soul. But that's all right. But he is feeling pain when you are killing the animal. So you also feel pain. So why should you give pain to others? That is Lord Buddha's theory. Sadaya ridaya darsita pasu ghata nindasi yogya vidhi raha suti jatam. He denied that I don't accept Vedas. Because in Vedas there is sometimes recommendation, not for killing, but for giving rejuvenation to that animal. But killing in that sense is there for sacrifice. But Lord Buddha did not accept it, animal killing in sacrifice. Therefore, nindasi means he was criticizing. Nindasi yogya vidhi raha suti jata. Sadaya ridaya darsi. Why? You are so kind and compassionate. That is Krishna consciousness. God is very kind, very compassionate. He does not like. But when there is necessity, he can kill. But his killing and our killing is different. He's all good. Anyone killed by Krishna, he immediately gets salvation. These things are there. So, immeasurable. You cannot measure what is the soul, but the soul is there and the body is perishable. Even if you do not fight, you save the bodies of your grandfather and teacher and others as you are so much overwhelmed. So they are perishable. Antavati, today or tomorrow. Suppose your grandfather is already old. And so you do not kill him just now or say after 1 year, 6 months. He may die because he's already old. These are the arguments put forward. The main point is, Krishna warns Arjuna that he must fight. He must not deviate from his duty as a Kshatriya. He should not be overwhelmed by the bodily destruction. Therefore, he is giving instruction. The body is different from the soul, so don't think that the soul will be killed. You stand up and fight. This is the instruction. Thank you.